Hello and welcome to Recombu. I'm Tom Dehan and today we're going to be unboxing the Mighty Vibe. Now, with a name like that, you might be thinking this was some kind of sex toy, but couldn't be further from the truth. What this actually is a modern day version of, say, the iPod Shuffle. It's a very small music player, but what you can actually do with it is download music from Spotify and Amazon Music and take it with you, listen to it offline. So if you're a runner, that means you get to leave your phone at home. For someone like me, that's perfect because I hate bringing my phone with me on a run. Would much rather always bring my Garmin watch instead and listen to music there. But with the Mighty Vibe, I can technically leave my Garmin at home and take any old fitness tracker and still be able to listen to music. And yeah, we're going to have a look and see, what's in the box and get first impressions from it. So, let's dive in. And so here we are with the Mighty Vibe. Now, as you can probably tell, there's not much packaging here. It feels quite akin to, I guess, unboxing a iPhone or a Samsung Galaxy phone in 2021. Not a lot of guff here. And to be honest, with more affordable devices like this, smaller devices as well, I actually don't mind having, you know, less waste, just because, you know, do you really want another box cluttering up storage, especially for something this small? No, certainly not for me, and, you know, I don't mind this. It's not too bad. You know, tells you exactly what you get on the back. Spotify integration, which has since been bumped to also include Amazon Music, Bluetooth compatibility, and wired headphone jack, which we will see in a minute. Can transfer music over Wi-Fi. Yep, makes sense. And supposedly just over 1,000, storage for up to and slightly over 1,000 songs, which again, if you're taking this out on a run or on a marathon, 1,000 is plenty to get you through the day. So no more faff, no more talking. Let's just, a little bit of talking, but let's dive right in anyway. Let's have a look, see what you get here. Let's see if you can see in that. Let's take this bad boy out. Ooh, yeah, very minimalist packaging here, it has to be said. Although I do quite like this. Let's see if I bring that up to the camera a wee bit. That's quite nice. A little bit of, you know, active art happening here. I like that there's a, you know, you've got the things you might expect. You've got jogger here, someone's hiking, bit of yoga, cycling, and, you know, this all makes sense to me. There is snowboarding, props to you, and also ballet. I mean, sure, why not? Why not? Why the hell not? Let's have a look. Ooh, I was about to, oh, yeah, no, it does work that way. There we go. Here's the culprit. The Mighty Vibe. Huh, it's actually smaller than what I expected. I don't know why I thought it seemed bigger somehow inside that packet over there. But let me just bring this closer a wee bit so you can see how small this thing is. Like if I fit this in the palm of my hand, it's very, very small. Yeah, I guess the comparisons to an iPod Shuffle probably aren't that unwarranted. And as you can probably see on the back there, there is a little clip, which, yeah, get to pop that on. Sorry, folks, don't mean to accidentally swear there, but, you know, just giving an example of, you know, being able to pop that onto a shirt or whatever. And as you can probably already tell, there's no touchscreen here. So, yeah, all the all of the interactions with the Mighty Vibe are done via the physical buttons that are right there on the front-facing portion of the device. So, you know, if you had an iPod Nano or an iPod Shuffle, or really any iPod that had the wheel, yeah, this is kind of self-explanatory here. Volume up, volume down, I'm assuming that's probably skip tracks, play, obviously. This little button up here, I'm assuming, will be jumping up to the menus so that you can jump between playlists. And it seems as though that might be it as far as interaction goes. You know, there might be different types of things, you know, double clicks and whatnot that I will not be able to know until I actually test the thing out. So yeah, hopefully there's haven't missed anything too major out, but we'll find out when my final review goes live for this product. Now, as I mentioned earlier, up here there is a headphone jack, 3.5mm headphone jack, which, yeah, is quite nice to see, actually. Because, of course, you know, for certain audiophiles out there who still stick by having a wired, you know, pair of headphones, you know, it's not me. I have since moved on gladly to Bluetooth. I say, you know, the fewer wires, the better. But if it's there, if that's what you're into, you still have the option there to get that high quality audio when you're out on a run. And let's leave that there for a second and I suppose dive into what's... Well, actually, the funny thing is that it says start here, so maybe that's where I should have started. And instead of just going straight to the device. Anyway, you know, can't turn back time now. There we go. Right, let's see what's in here. Oh, it's quite minimalist, it has to say. Has to be said. So it really is just, here's the charging cable, which would go, presumably, straight into, yeah, that headphone port right there. And because there really isn't any other port on the device, so it would have to be that. Yeah, so that's how you charge it. It's a very small charging cable, has to be said. Let's have a look. Yeah, that runs pretty much just to about my wrist if I were to sprawl it out over my hand. Yeah, not that long a cable, but I guess what they're assuming is that you'd be charging this at your laptop, so you'd have it there, you know, next to your device, so not the worst thing in the world. Let's pop that back into some sort of semblance there. And a little bit of paperwork for your troubles as well. Let's see. Yep, standard stuff. Lets you know what you need to do. There's an app that you need to download that works in conjunction with the Mighty Vibe. Without the app, as far as I'm aware, you can't download music to it. So that app is essential. And yeah, that seems to be about it, really. Ah, there is a bit of instructions here with regards to the blinking light function, which is up here just next to the menu button. There's different functions there. It says green, powering on, blinking, solid orange, powering off, blue, waiting to pair, white, fully charged. Yeah, all standard stuff. I guess that's nice to have. I've had a couple of devices in the past where they just have the tiniest little lights that are just very hard to see. At least that, you know, has a decent bit of retail space there. And yeah, I mean, look, folks, that is quite literally it. There is nothing else to unbox with the Mighty Vibe, but you know what? I don't mind that too much. You know, less waste, less guff to go through, and it gets you straight to the real star of the show here. And hey, if you enjoyed this unboxing, please, you know, give this video a like. Hey, even better if you give our channel a subscribe. That always goes a long way to supporting Recombu, so, you know, thanks in advance if you do. And you can expect to see our full review for the Mighty Vibe coming to Recombu very soon.